Welcome to episode 4 of the Chevy pickup truck project. I think it has now been a 3-year ordeal, keeping me very, very broke. Last episode, we dropped it at Kelbscott sandblasting for some epoxy coating. And in this episode, it gets painted. So I was going to do it myself, but I was having a lot of problems with the compressor and getting the spray settings right, and I didn't want to screw it up. So found a guy named Alex who did a great job for me. So enjoy the episode.
Well, I got my first truck when I was 3, drove 100,000 miles on my knees, hauling marbles and rocks, and thought it twice before I hauled a Barbie doll bed for the girl next door. She tried to pay me with a kiss, and I began to understand it's something women like about a pickup man. When I turned 16, I saved a few $100. My first car was a pickup truck. I was cruising the town, and the first girl I seen was Bobby Joe Gentry, the homecoming queen. She flagged me down and climbed up in the cab and said, I never knew you were a pickup man. You can set my truck on fire and roll it down a hill, and I still wouldn't trade it for a cup of divot. I got an 8-foot bed that never has to be made. You know, if it weren't for trucks, it wouldn't have tailgates. I met all my wives in traffic jams. It's just something women like about a pickup man. Most Friday nights, I could be found in the bed of my truck on an old chase line. Back in my spot at the drive-in show, you know, the cargo lights give off a romantic glow. I never have to wait in line at the popcorn stand, cause there's something women like about a pickup man. You could set my truck on fire and roll it down a hill, and I still wouldn't trade it for a coupe de ville. I got an 8-foot bed that never has to be made. You know, if it weren't for trucks, you wouldn't have tailgates. I met all my wives in traffic jams. It is something women like about a pickup man. What's around the block, and you know what I mean. You can set my truck on fire and roll it down a hill, and I still wouldn't trade it for a coupe de ville. I got an 8-foot bed that never has to be made. You know, if it weren't for trucks, you wouldn't have tailgates. I met all my wives in traffic jams. It's just something women like about a pickup man. Something women like about a pickup man.
Oh, drop that pickup now, boys. That's about it.
So what you don't see in this episode is a lot of the mechanical stuff that I was doing, which is like the brakes, front and rear, took the diff out, got a true track put in it, new bearings, put it back in the car, all those sorts of things. You saw it getting loaded up on the trailer at the end there, which I think has happened almost every episode. It's now gone back to a workshop to get all the fiddly bits done. And I've found with building my EK Holden back in the day, it was the fiddly bits which took the longest amount of time. So getting someone to do that, they'll be able to do it a lot faster than me. And hopefully that will see me on the road a bit sooner rather than later, because I'm itching to drive it. So hopefully next episode you might see it driving down the street. Thanks for watching.